Hi, my name is Lonnie Johnson. Welcome to my channel. I got a 50 horsepower Mercury outboard motor on this boat behind me. I know the solenoid switch is bad, and I'll show you why I know it's bad. I went to start the motor because I wanted to go fishing. It would drag like the starter was going out. So I went ahead, pulled the plugs out. Then it cranked over. I put the plugs back in. The battery would still sound like it was going bad because the starter was dragging. Went and bought a brand new battery. Then it didn't do anything at all. It just wasn't doing nothing. So let me go through this with you and show you what's going on. Stick around. This is the brand new battery. I'm going to go ahead and turn the power on by flipping this key. I'm going to put the multimeter right there on 20 volts. It's reading 13.9 volts. The old battery read 12.4 volts. Now, I'm going to go over here to the ignition switch, show you what it sounds like. I'm going to put the key in ignition. I'm going to turn it. And there's nothing. So, I'm going to take the key out of the ignition. I'm going to go back to the back. Okay, I'm going to take the cover off. Okay, right here's my solenoid. Here's my starter. Okay, now I'm going to get in here where you can see a little better. Okay, I got my multimeter on 20 volts. What I'm going to do, I'm going to check and see if I'm getting voltage through the key switch. I'm going to ground this out right here. Where the starter's at. I'm going to put it on the key switch right here. Okay, turn the key. Okay, and we're getting 11.92 volts. Okay, let off the key. Okay, now I'm going to put it down here and I want to see if this solenoid's kicking in enough to put 11 volts through this. Okay, do it again. See, there's nothing there, so the solenoid's bad. So I have to replace the solenoid. Okay, let me do that again. Hold on. I knew it was a solenoid. Let me get a better ground here just to make sure. Put that on the bottom, so when the solenoid kicks in, the power goes from here down to here, and from there it goes to the starter. Okay, do it. Yep, you can hear some clicking on the solenoid. Okay, do it again. You can hear clicking on the solenoid, but it's not making contact. Okay, turn the key off. Okay, now, if I take this right here, this is the battery, this should be hot. So if I put that there, let me put this meter where you can see it. I ground it, I get 12.95 volts. So it's definitely the solenoid is bad. So I don't have to check the starter. The starter is not gonna be an issue. This is the starter switch that I made. I told you in an earlier video when I made this that I'd show you how it works and how I use it. And right now I'm going to show you that. So right here's the solenoid. This wire here is hot, like I showed you before. I'm going to take my red lead, I'm going to put it right there. Take my black lead, put it right here. And where I put this is the wire that's coming from the key switch. And if I push this button right here, you can hear a little bit of a click. It's not really activating the solenoid fully, and it's just barely clicking. So I know that it's not my key switch. Now I'll just take this one off and I'll put it on the bottom of the solenoid here. Now I'll push the button and it's wanting to turn over. So I know it's the solenoid switch that's bad. First thing you want to do is disconnect your battery, because this wire right here is always hot when the battery's connected.
I'm going to go ahead and remove this nut right here. Now I'm going to go ahead and remove this nut and this nut. Go ahead and remove your wires. Now I'm going to go ahead and take this bolt and this bolt out. Now as you can see here, this one right here comes right around to here, and that is your ground. So that will come off and go right back on. Okay, it's loose. I will go ahead and pull it out of there. And that's what it looks like. And that wire will go right back on the new one. As you can see, the new part came with all the hardware. I'll have to remove these. I won't be using those. Okay, I got the wire on there running down. I got the bolt through there. That is a 9/32 socket. These here take a 5/16 socket. I'll go ahead and mount those on up in there. Just got to line the holes up and get the bolt started. Okay, once you get them started by hand, then you can go ahead and start tightening them up with the socket and ratchet. Now I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put the wires on. This one will go on first. Now I'll go ahead and hook these wires up. Now these are 10 millimeter. Okay, that takes care of replacing our new solenoid. Now to test it and see if it will crank over. I'm going to go turn the power on to the battery, put the key in, and try and start it. If it starts, I'm not going to let it run long because I don't have no water hooked up to it. So let's see what it does. Okay, that solved the problem. $13 solenoid, and I'm ready to go fishing. Like, comment, subscribe, share with your friends. Thanks for watching.